So I kind of feel like this plant looks like a Dr. Seuss plant, and I'm going to be like reaching over it with my neck. I need a longer neck. But you might recognize this plant. This is called Beacarnea recurvata, otherwise known as Ponytail Palm. And recurvata just means that it's curving back, and I think that's probably referring to the fact of its lovely punky foliage that you see here. The other thing that you'll also notice is that it has this really chunky stem, this caudex or caudiciform. It's very swollen, and this is where it stores all of its water. So this is a plant that's not going to want a lot of water. And you want to make sure, this is a little bit more of a grower's mix, but you want to make sure that the soil kind of remains dry. You want to moisten it, but make sure that it dries out for quite some time in between, because you don't want this having mushy roots. Now, this is a plant that if you have full sun or bright direct light, then this is going to love that. It's going to love you for that. So you want to be able to give this the kind of right conditions. I actually had a larger one growing back in the day, but it got a little bit too large. It was fairly large that when I got it, and it just wasn't fitting in my house anymore. So I ended up getting a smaller diminutive one, which, by the way, these are pretty slow growers. So you're not going to have to worry about it getting huge unless you actually buy one that's huge to begin with. Now, this is a plant that gets really beautiful flowers on top, but I've actually never seen them as a houseplant with flowers. But it kind of looks like a little bit of pampas grass that you just want to kind of like put your hand over the top of it, and it has this like really light, fluffy, kind of yellowish look on top, which is really, really beautiful. So you can actually propagate these by little offsets off the side, or you could propagate this by seed, but I'd imagine the seed would take a very, very long time. Now, as far as fertilizing this goes, it doesn't need a lot of fertilizer. If you're actually like changing out the soil every 2 years or so, then you probably are not gonna need to fertilize it at all. I would say on an annual basis, you're gonna be fine with a 2-4-7 or a 3-4-7 or even a slow release fertilizer. So those are the little fertilizer balls. They look like little plastic balls. Sometimes they have really different colors, and you kind of work them into the soil, and that's a little bit more of a slow release fertilizer. I wouldn't do the fertilizer sticks unless they're organic fertilizer sticks, because those synthetic ones you kind of put into the soil, and it could actually disturb some of the roots on that one side of the plant, and it doesn't really distribute the fertilizer in a cohesive manner. It just kind of distributes the fertilizer in that little one part of where it is. So that's why I would like defer away from those ones. Now, I will also say that this is a plant that I know a lot of people with cats, curious kitties, likes to eat. And I do not think, don't quote me on this, you are gonna have to double check, that this, I don't think this is poisonous to cats. However, it is just beckoning for a kitty in order to be able to play with this and eat this. And you can see that I have not stopped touching this plant throughout this whole episode here, because it just beckons to be played with. And it looks a little bit like grass or wheatgrass or something that a cat is going to want to nibble on. And I have to say that if anything, try to keep it away from your cat, or else it's going to have like mangled leaves. And maybe you could even get one of those like big bird's cages that you could actually put this in and have it hanging, you know, from your ceiling or from a window, so that it actually gets away from the cat, so no kitty will play with it. Now, if you have a good cat that doesn't eat your plants, then you're probably all good to go. But otherwise, this is a wonderful plant to have if you have the right conditions for it.